I'm Bakhtiar. I'm Uyghur. Since 1949, East Turkestan been occupied by China and given us a new name as Xinjiang Uyghur Autonomous Region. Since the day we've been treated as a second-class citizen in our home country. So there is unfairness of the human rights and the justice in our country. The mainly is for the Uyghur kids since from the age of six, they've been taught in Chinese. So later on, all their movement and education, everything is going to be taught in Chinese. In our workplaces, we don't have rights to practice or pray our religion. And our culture heritage been demolished by Chinese. The ancient city of Kashgar, which has 2,000 years of history, now being demolished since 2006. I came to Australia as international student at the beginning, and I came right after my parents came. We had to claim political protection as a refugee. My personal hope is study hard in a university in Australia, study human legal system of Australia and the international laws. Economic interests shouldn't be override our human rights. The Australian government can let the China or let the world hear our voice.
My name's Mariam and I'm Afghan. There are several human rights issues in Afghanistan. I think the fundamental ones that seems to get a lot of focus at the moment is women's rights. And I guess the other thing that is also quite an enormous issue at the moment is that we've still got foreign intervention. We've got Afghanistan has been occupied for many years now. Poverty and unemployment all stems from the fact that there hasn't been stability in Afghanistan. That stability hasn't been there since, one could argue, since the 1970s. My uncle sponsored us to come over here. Our journey obviously started off in Afghanistan, but we moved to India to escape from the war and then made it to Australia. The challenges facing Afghans in general is probably, you know, similar challenges facing most Muslims living in Australia. And fundamentally, you know, a lot of those issues tend to impact on Muslim women, particularly those who choose to wear the hijab. I've said this on many occasions, I am definitely not a fan of the burqa. However, it is a fundamental right of any human being living in Australia to be able to exercise, you know, exercise their freedom of expression. And if a woman chooses to, is not forced to, but chooses to wear the burqa, that is her right. I came to this country with, you know, hopes and aspirations, as every other young individual does. And for me, for a long time, I wanted to desperately become a lawyer. Luckily, I've, you know, managed to pull that off, and I work in the legal industry now. What I want to do with my skills is hopefully get to a point in the future where I can utilise those skills to help advance the cause of Muslims in Australia and across the world.
I am Mohammed. I'm from Ghana. Ghana has, in the past, enjoyed some developments in many fields, but human rights is still an issue at the moment. The biggest problems that are facing our country is in the area of unemployment and poverty. At the moment, we have more than 40% of illiteracy rate in the country, and there is also a big inequality when it comes to education, gender inequality in education. Yeah, as part of trying to solve some of these human rights issues, I set up organizations in my community. Call it Youth Against Deprivation. Our aim is to educate the rural dwellers, especially the youth. Yeah, my challenges are the same as challenges of any African person of African descent. But personally, I don't see much involvement of the African community, the Ghanaian community, or bigger Australian society. There are problems with racism. That is a massive area. And it is my hope to set up an African study center. Just to make sure that I'm able to boost the African human rights agenda in Australia. That's what I want to do.
My name is Rohit. I'm from Bhutan. Bhutan is made of three ethnic groups. They are Nalong, Sarsop, and Lochampa. Bhutan government introduced there is no more Nepalese language in the southern part of the school, and they have compulsion to wear the traditional clothes because of those policy brought by government. And there's a different, like, arresting the people from the village, shooting them. And in the same story, like, my grandfather is arrested from house twice, and he was put in the jail. And because of those torture and marginalized, we moved to Nepal, and where we become a refugee. Like every day, I have to look for something to get, like even a evening food or for my study, I have to ask for someone. But now, I can do myself. I'm being independent now. I can do myself. Even the other Bhutanese family, other people, they don't need any more of, like, they are no more dependent. They can do by themselves, and they are, like, being able to stand their own feet.
My name is Janine, and I'm Palestinian. My dad was born and raised in a refugee camp in Lebanon, and he came to Australia in his late 20s. My mother was born in the Emirates. Palestinians are subjected to a brutal military occupation by Israel. Palestinians don't have much freedom of movement. They have to endure waiting up at, you know, security checkpoints, military checkpoints. Dehumanized Palestinians could end up, you know, lining up for several hours and, you know, being interrogated, being humiliated, you know, being subjected to things that nobody has to be subjected to. They don't have much freedom of movement, and that's because of the West Bank separation barrier, the apartheid wall that snakes its way around and within the West Bank. Israel has subjected the Palestinians in Gaza to a blockade. They're not allowing, you know, building construction materials to come in, medicine, I guess, food. The challenges that face the Palestinian community in Australia. You know, people demonizing the Palestinians. Palestinians are always portrayed as, you know, the terrorists.
My name is Danich, and I'm from Thailand. In southern majority is Islam, is Muslim. And because they speak different language as well. They speak like Malayu, like Bahasa Malaysia. So they can't communicate like very well with government. What happened now is a lot of people, they live without freedom, and all happened in every single, like, in every single hour. They got, like, explosions, they got bombs, just put in jail, that's it, yeah. Because of they are all Muslims. The policy, even, like, the government or even ours, we try to, you know, we try to work cooperate, we try to work together. I came here for last year, about 9-10 months, for study college, and maybe next year, inshallah, gonna study uni, yeah, maybe master.
My name is Salim Tabik, and peace be upon you. I'm Lebanese-Australian, and I'm happy to talk to you today. My parents originally came from Lebanon, and I was born here in Australia. I'm a part of Australia and a part of Lebanon. I see myself between the two nations as one. My identity is Muslim. The biggest challenge is to put down their feelings, from their hatred and everything that's going around the world in their home countries, and try to settle down, get a job, and make a change using their heads, using their brains, and not to resort to violence. That's the biggest challenge right now. Right now, my hopes and aspirations are to study at university, hopefully engineering, get a good job, earn some money, and then put it back into the society.
Human rights.
Human rights are our rights.
Peace.
Human rights are your rights.
Freedom.
Freedom of expression is our right.
Say no to racism.
I'm not oppressed.
And I'm not oppressed.